I have a Taylor Swift quiz for you today.
What? This is shocking.
Well, see, the last Taylor Swift quiz that I did for you was based off of, it was like a football edition. So
I remember it was, yeah, very, I was confused.
It was the day of the Super Bowl.
Right.
And I decided that people are 50% talking about the Super Bowl and they're 50% talking about Taylor Swift.
Sure.
And Travis Kelce. So I did like a 50-50 yeah, quiz for you.
Actually, it makes a lot of sense with the whole Travis thing.
Yeah.
They're dating. Travis Kelce and Taylor Swift are dating.
Breaking news.
Yeah. Yeah, they've been dating for a while.
Oh. Heck. Okay.
I wonder how it's going.
I don't know.
I wish somebody would cover that in the news.
Brian claims on almost a daily basis that he is a Swiftie by osmosis, just meaning that our four teenagers talk about Taylor Swift enough that he absorbs.
Right. Not by choice. Right. It's not like I like go out and try and learn stuff about Taylor Swift.
Right. Just to like, you should do that. Just to like surprise them one day. Come up with a fact about Taylor Swift.
I have. One time I looked up some random stuff on the internet. Oh, I was trying to convince the girls that Taylor Swift had a twin sister. And so I went on the internet and I tried to see if she has any siblings, which I forgot if she does. I think she has a sister, maybe.
Dang, I wish that was going to be one of my questions. But anyways, she has a brother.
Here's the best part.
Okay.
Is that I found some guy's blog that had, he had like a fan fiction like article about how she has a twin sister, and he had made like a picture that had two of them like together. Like,
I
hugging.
Love it.
And I took a screenshot of it. I was messing with them. Yeah. I saw this article. I took a screenshot of the picture of two Taylor Swifts together. And then I took a screenshot of the first part of the article that didn't say that it was a joke. And I sent it to them and they didn't think it was funny.
Okay.
Our kids did not think it was funny.
Do you think
I thought it was hilarious.
Oh, I did too. Did they balk at all? Like, were they at all like,
no.
Okay.
No, but I still say that she is a twin. Just if I say it enough, it might.
Right. Can I be honest? I actually remember that. And I actually thought that you took the time to edit that photo, but you didn't. You just screamed.
No, I don't know how to do that.
Yes, you do.
Unless there's like a new AI thing now where it says show two Taylor Swifts together.
I'm sure there is.
There probably is.
I'm sure there is. Okay. Squirrel. So I came up with another Taylor Swift quiz for you that's strictly based on Taylor Swift. And then what I thought we could do was we could send this out to all the kids and they can have their dads take the quiz to see if they score better than you.
All right.
Okay. So you're really trying here to beat other dads. Like, you don't want our kids saying that our dad came in last.
So I'm like really scared.
No pressure.
Because they will not let me live it down.
No pressure. Okay. Are you ready for the first question? There's 15 questions.
I am ready.
Okay.
For the first question. 15 questions?
Yeah.
That's a lot. I feel like I've already answered hundreds. Okay. Go ahead.
What genre was Taylor Swift's first album?
It would be like country or pop country, maybe? Country.
Okay. I was going to say, go with your gut. Go with your gut. It was country.
But it was kind of like wasn't it like not twangy country? It was like more like pop country.
No, it's pretty twangy.
Okay. I should have just said country.
In fact, she's re-releasing her first album, which I'm not going to say the name of, because I think that one of my questions is what was the name of Taylor Swift's first album?
Yeah, I won't know that.
And I was literally talking with one of our girls and I said, I don't know how she's going to like re-sing that because she does not sound the same.
I see what you're saying.
Very twangy. A lot of cowbell sound.
Maybe she'll popify it.
Yeah.
She's allowed to do that.
She is. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Second question. What female pop star is the song Bad Blood said to be about?
Female pop star?
Uh-huh.
Wasn't it Katy Perry?
Yes, it was.
Holy crap. I have no idea how I know that.
Woo,
because to be honest with you.
Osmosis. That's
it really is.
Literally your whole point.
I can't even tell you what happened between them. It's
okay. Then that will be in the quiz like in a year from now when you have even more Taylor Swift knowledge. That will be the question. Right. So try and pick that stuff up.
Didn't she steal like backup dancers or something?
Yes.
It's coming back to me.
Question number three. I want you to finish this line.
Okay. You know what? I recognize the song, but I have no idea.
It's like one of my...
I don't listen to the lyrics in this song very much. I know I've heard it in the background a billion times.
I played it actually twice for you. It's... she says it two times in a row. Please don't have someone waiting on you.
Oh, I actually thought about saying that.
Oh, but why didn't you say it?
Because I figured you would never let me have that something that easy.
But if you don't know it, it's not easy.
Yeah, that's true.
That's why this whole thing is about osmosis. It's what have you picked up? It's not stuff you should have learned in school.
So I learned a valuable lesson on question three. I should just say it. Whatever.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Question number four. What is the name of the tour Taylor Swift is on right now?
Eras.
Yeah.
You know what's funny?
You didn't even hesitate. Yeah.
So I thought it was Eras, A-R-E-S. I thought it was just like some like mystical word.
Oh.
I-S or.
Just something she made
just
up.
Just like, yeah, like I think there's like a Greek god or something.
That's what I was. Yeah. That's what I think. Like Aries.
Yeah. And so I was thinking that's what the name was. And then I realized it, I think, when we took the kids to the movie. It took me that long. Yeah, I think when we took the kids to the movie and I was like, oh, it's Eras.
Eras.
And I
was
like, I get it, because she's doing a couple songs from each of her albums. I'm like, right. I get it.
Okay. But you knew it.
But I'm just being transparent. Like, you know, sometimes you do dumb stuff and sometimes you do not dumb stuff. And that was dumb.
I'm okay with it.
I tend to err on the dumb stuff. Go ahead.
This next question is a multiple choice question.
All right. I appreciate that.
Question number five. Is Taylor Swift a cat person or a dog person?
Dog. It's a guess.
No.
Oh, she's a cat?
You literally said one time, what are you going to make me name all of Taylor Swift's cats? I figured you would know this one.
Oh, I probably just joked about that.
She's a cat person. She has three cats. No, I can't name them.
I bet she's around them quite a bit.
Question number six. What is the name of the song that Taylor Swift is crying at the gym?
Crying at the gym. Shoot, I actually remember that lyric somewhere.
I know. That's why I'm asking the question.
It's probably one of the new songs.
It's one of the new songs.
Let me tell you, that album was released and it's been on the speakers in our house 24/7 for the entire since that. When was it released? Like, it seems April, like years ago.
April 19th.
And today is what?
May Cinco de Mayo. Oh, should I Cinco de Mayo?
So it's only been out for a week? Holy crap, man. I've probably heard every one of those songs at least 50 times for each song. And there's 30 songs or something?
31.
Yeah, so 150.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, 30 times.
So does that mean you don't know the song that goes, crying at the
gym?
All
right,
okay.
Crying at the gym. Something about like a dad, like daddy, I love him or something like that.
No, but that is a good song.
Oh, then I don't know.
Down bad, crying down at bad. The gym.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know the song titles. Wait, it's called Down Bad, Crying at the Gym?
It's just called Down Bad.
Oh, Down Bad. Okay.
What was the name of Taylor Swift's first debut single?
Like from when she was little?
For her very first debut single.
Christmas Tree Farm.
You love that song.
Well, it's just, I know it's an older one. And
I know the girls have said it in your presence before.
See, I am just not somebody, like my favorite bands, I don't know the names of songs. So like this is going to be always challenging for me.
You want me to tell you?
I know the track numbers usually. That's about it.
Do you want me to tell you?
Sure.
Tim McGraw.
That's the name of the song?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I wouldn't, I guess.
Okay.
She kind of used like a trending topic to get her song out there.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, literally.
Because back then, Tim McGraw was very trending.
Like, she's like, if I name it Tim McGraw,
yeah,
should probably get some playtime. Okay. Would you agree, though?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just like a marketing.
Sure. Question number eight. How long is a fortnight?
Oh, shit. I actually looked this up the other day. For something, and I don't even know if it was Taylor Swift related. It's 2 weeks.
Yes. And it is, you don't know if it's Taylor Swift related. We looked it up because of the song Fortnite.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I didn't know if I was talking about the Constitution, the United States Constitution.
No.
Wait, no, no.
You linked it to that. No. So you were probably talking about
that. But that's not in the Constitution for the record. But like when they talk about Fortnites, you think about like revolutionary times. At least that's what I think about. I don't think about Taylor Swift.
Sure.
Four song score title. And 7 years ago. What score? Is that like a year?
I don't know.
That's like 26 Fortnites or what? Okay, sorry.
I don't know. You want to look it up?
I don't know. Whenever Taylor Swift has a four score song, then I'll look it up.
Okay. Question number 9.
Ready.
Finish this song title.
Okay.
Cruel.
Summer.
Yes.
I guess I do know some lyrics.
I swear to God, titles. I thought you were going to say Intentions. Did you want to say Intentions?
No, I know that's a movie.
Okay.
That's a 90s movie.
It is a 90s movie. Question number 10. Who is the song Dear John about?
Definitely John Stamos.
Because they dated?
Well, no. She always had a crush on him when he was on Full House.
Uh-huh.
So, and then he doesn't age, so she's just continued to watch him through mm-hmm. his career. And no, it's fact. Look it up.
Okay. So is that your answer? John Stamos? John Stamos.
It's 100%. I don't need phone to friend. I'm good.
Okay.
Locked in.
It's about John Mayer.
John Mayer?
They dated.
She might say that in public because she's embarrassed to the John Stamos. Okay. But I know because I've looked it up.
This next one is a finish this line.
So. Oh, okay. You know what I mean, or something like that. You
wouldn't know what I mean. Yes, that's pretty good.
You wouldn't know what I mean. Got it. Oh, because the person she's talking to doesn't
right.
keep their side of the street.
That was a good, I'll give you a point for that one.
All right.
That's pretty good.
I actually liked some of the lyrics in that song.
Yeah.
It's pretty.
Yeah.
It's she like actually fundamentally like everyone should kind of pay attention to that kind of.
We live in a society.
We live in a society, so don't be a jerk.
Don't be an
asshole. Do the right thing.
Question number 12. How long is Taylor's version of All Too Well?
Jeez. I do know that I'm going to talk this out like it's
okay.
like we're in Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Because they have to drag it out for the whole show or whatever.
Sure.
So I've definitely heard the girls, like if we're on our like road trip for vacation, uh-huh. I've heard the girls say, play some song, the long version.
Uh-huh.
And I'm guessing since you're asking me about the length of the song, that it might be this song. And I want to say it's in the, okay. So the reason I know it's somewhere in like the 9 minute range. And the reason I think that is because I remember one time I was like, how long is the long version? And they were like, 9 minutes. And I said, okay, but then I get to pick a Fish song that I like, which was, I have a live version of Ghost that I play that's 23 minutes long.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of my favorite versions of that song.
Good golly. When we go to the Fish concert this summer, can I go get like a drink during that song? And yeah. I'm not going to miss a thing, right?
You're going to go get a drink during, you think they only have one 20 minute song?
Oh God.
Almost all of them are going to be like 15 to 20 minutes.
What do? How long can you dance to the same song?
It'll be all right. But yeah, you can definitely, I would encourage you get a drink so you don't want me to leave early.
Did I mention how much I'm looking forward to this concert?
I doubt you are. I can't wait to hear a synopsis of it after the concert.
I will do. I will.
I'm actually really interested to see what you think afterwards.
Okay.
This is going to be great.
Okay. So how long was Taylor's?
I'm going to say it's in the 9 minute range.
Close. 10 minutes.
Okay. I mean,
it literally says 10 minute version in the title.
Can I get 9/10? If there's 10 minutes and I got 9, I feel like I should get 90% credit on that.
I'll see what they say.
Because 9 out of 10 minutes.
I'll see what they say.
They. Oh, okay.
I'll see what they say.
All right. I'm they'll back me up. I'm just a dad trying his best here.
You are. You're doing actually really well.
Thanks. This is, I'm like This is nail biting. I'm really nervous. My palms are sweaty.
Oh, boo. You have three more. You're almost there. Okay. Question 13.
Okay.
In what song does Taylor Swift reference what age she feels like? And what is the age she feels like?
Yeah, that's... Sorry. I don't know.
You do, because you answered it one time. When I asked you what was Taylor Swift's favorite number.
1989?
No.
That's when she was born.
It's a year.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember. I'm sorry.
22.
Oh, okay. That's awesome. I didn't even know that where I got that when I said 22.
I know. You really did guess that. Do you remember guessing that now?
I remember guessing 22, yeah. But after I said it, I immediately thought that has nothing to do with her. It's just a nice number because there's two twos. That doesn't ring a bell. I believe you, though.
Okay. Question 14. What street does Taylor Swift never want to walk again now that her and Joe have broken up?
Shoot. I actually heard this song.
It's a good song.
Rider? Does it start with an R?
Nope.
I'm not going to be able to pull this out of my ass, but I know that I know what you're referring to. She definitely says that in a song.
Yep.
She's got a house on there, maybe.
She rents a place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and they live there together, and now she doesn't want.
I'll does never she still walk live there? Street again.
Rider? Oh, you said it doesn't start with an R.
It doesn't.
Does it start with a D?
No. We start.
C?
Yes.
It is a C?
Mm-hmm.
Cyprus?
Nope.
Okay, go ahead.
Never lose you, hope it never ends. I never walk Cornelia Street again.
Cornelia. Okay, that does ring a bell.
Okay.
Now that you said it.
Last one. Finish this line.
Your past and mine are parallel lines, stars all aligned, and they intertwined. And taught you the way you call me baby, treat me like a lady, all that I can say is all of the girls you loved before.
Maybe like tell them to walk out the door or something.
Made you the one.
Oh, yeah. I remember that now.
Yeah.
But I couldn't remember it.
That's okay.
I wish you would have given me that first part.
That first line?
Yeah.
Sorry.
I would have nailed it. Although I would have said all of the girls. Yeah. All of the girls you've lived. I probably would have got that.
Okay. Even before I played the chorus, you would have gotten that?
Yeah. That's like okay. If you would have stopped it right before the chorus. Okay. But, you know, woulda, coulda, shoulda.
Well, I didn't. Which is also a Taylor Swift song.
That's why I said it. I'm just kidding. I had no idea. It's pure luck.
All right, babe. That's your Taylor Swift quiz. I'll add them up later and figure out how many you got right or wrong.
Yeah. I'd say it seemed like about half, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. See, if you get that 9/10, we'll see.
God, I hope I do better than other dads.